Good evening. My name is Jonathan Romeo. Welcome to the Crooked Road Youth Music Series concert. We have music here at Heartwood every Thursday night. We've got jams on the first, third, and fifth Thursdays. Youth music concerts on the second Thursdays, and venue showcases on the fourth Thursday. So please come out and support live music here at Heartwood. If you like what you hear tonight, you'd care to leave a donation in the box on the way out, we'd appreciate it. We don't charge admission for these concerts, but we do have production costs, and those donations help with the production costs. I'd like to just mention June 12th through 20th is Mountains of Music Homecoming, and we've got 34 concerts and over 260 cultural events throughout the region of Southwest Virginia, 19 county, 4 city region, June 12th through 20th. So if you're interested, please pick up a brochure on the way out. They're at the tables here or in the racks. And those concerts are made possible by a lot of different sponsors. Please thank the sponsors, and we appreciate your support. So without further ado, I'll make welcome, please, Tyler Hughes and Linda Jean Stokely.
Not too long. We're going to get back to the mountains we're planning. That's we're just taking off for a vacation. Linda and I can proudly say we both just graduated college this past Saturday. And we promised ourselves a big vacation if we could make it through. And we made it. So
I called Tyler about a month ago crying, talking about how horrible my semester was. He said, honey, I cried outside the library today. So we both had a little bit of a meltdown about before it ended, but he graduated from ETSU and I graduated from Morehead State University, and now it's just time to play music for a while.
That's that's what we're going to do. We're going to play a tune here called Shove That Pig's Foot a Little Further in the Fire.
Distant land, Mother said, my dear boy.
words she said to me as she took me by the hand. If on earth we meet no more, we would be in God's right hand. Father said, my dear boy,
my boy,
I hope to see you next year again.
A person and spectacle, And I accidentally wrote a love song about him, and I didn't mean to. He hops trains. He's a real modern day hobo, and I always have just admired that about him for some bizarre reason. But I wrote this song in a series of redhead yodels. This is redhead yodel number one, or commonly as mainliner. This is a little waltz about Matt Kinman.
Silence when we could all see.
See what kind of coal they had down in there. So they brought all kinds of equipment in, a big crane and a big drill and so on. They took that big drill and they went down behind the barn and drilled a big hole about 3,000 feet deep, pulled that core sample off. I reckon they shipped it out to Virginia Tech or somewhere and find out what kind of coal's down in there. Well, while all this was happening, the wife of the farmer who had the truck down at the Food City, she'd gone to trade and get groceries. Come back home and she was fixing supper. And while she was fixing supper, she looked out and she could see the mining men coming back. They'd come back to fill in that big hole. And how they fill in those big holes, they just drop dynamite down there about 50 or 75 feet, set it off, and they let it cave in. So they were just about to light that dynamite when the farmer come running in. He said, "Hang on just a second." I said, "Don't light that dynamite." I said, "Y'all can save me a whole lot of trouble, and I can save you from using that dynamite." I said, "I've been needing to dig a hole for my outhouse for quite some time." This is a true story. Y'all laugh, but it's true. He said, "You all could just take that crane and wrap it up around that outhouse, swarp it over there, over top that 3,000 foot deep hole." Well, after a little back and forth, they decided this would be best. They would go ahead. That would save them the dynamite. Times are hard. I mean, they're getting better, but they're still mighty hard, so they figured they ought to save the money on that dynamite. So they took the crane and they wrapped it up around the outhouse and they swarped it over top that 3,000 foot deep hole. Well, the wife had been inside. She was busy making supper and she didn't know what was going on out there. A few minutes later, of course, she had to visit the outhouse. Well, she was out there for a little bit, a little while longer. was a little bit longer past, and all of a sudden, one of the kids come busting through the screen door. He said, "Daddy, Daddy," said, "Mommy's in the outhouse and she's turning blue." He said, "Oh, that's all right," said, "she'll be okay in a minute. She just likes to hold her breath until she hears it hit bottom." Now I'm going to sing you a real pretty song written by a real wonderful songwriter from over in Wise County. She doesn't get enough credit in my book. Her name is Kate Peter Sturgill. She wrote a really lovely gospel song called Deep Settled Peace. You might have heard some people sing that, like John McCutcheon. But she just had such a poetic way of putting words together and really unique stuff. So she wrote this song about her home, our home, Stone Mountain. It's called My Stone Mountain Home. Nestled in the heart of the hills, where the trailing arbutus grows, where the red rhododendrons bloom on the hills, as they ride longing to go. Sweet memories return to my childhood anew, when I used to wander there. Happy hours I'd spend by the old mill stream, with never sorrow or care. I'm longing for my dear old home, that old home in Stone Mountain far away, where at twilight you can hear the whippoorwills call and the birds all the day. Where the catawba tree blooms by the side of the path, in the dear old familiar spot. Although many years have passed away, it was never been forgot. Where the peat-bound calls warning to approach the storm, you hear the humming of bees. Where the cattle and sheep graze on the hill, is home to me. I'm longing for my dear old home, that old home in Stone Mountain far away, where at twilight you can hear the whippoorwills call and the birds sing all the day. I'm longing for my dear old home, that old home in Stone Mountain far away, where at twilight you can hear the whippoorwills call and the birds sing all the day.
Yeah.
We'll do another gospel song here. We probably need to repent a little bit by this time in the show. After my dirty joke. Oops. Alright, well, this is another one the Carter family recorded. And I was real lucky. I play with a group out of Johnson City called the Empty Bottle String Band. Look us up on Facebook. We were part of a really great show with the Birthplace of Country Music just a few weeks ago. The Birthplace of Country Music teamed up with the Bristol Ballet Company and did a really wonderful show called Unbroken Circle. This was a song that we sang in that. It was a very unique show, as you might have imagined, ballet, old-time country music, but they made it work. Made it work. Yeah. Such as the Junior Appalachian Musicians or summer camps like Mountain Music School. So I really encourage you guys, if you haven't given a donation, I really encourage you to give a donation tonight, because without those types of programs, a lot of students in this region don't have any access to musical instruments and really don't even have access to this music. We like to think that it was handed down generation after generation, and it was, but unfortunately, as more technology has become involved in our lives, we've sort of seen this music disappear in some places. So that's a really great way to keep this tradition alive. So really encourage you to support the Youth Music Initiative. Now this is an old mean man, Rob Bill Jones.
Said that love is a pleasure, Lord.
You
Let's hear it one more time for Tyler Hughes and Linda Jean Strickland.